Welcome back to Pastry Maestra. I'm Teresa and today I'm making crème chantilly. Chantilly. Try to pronounce it with that French nasal sound. It sounds so aristocratic and fancy, right? At first I thought chantilly is just a name for a cream. But when I became curious and started to explore, to my surprise, I found that many other things have that same name. So, let me tell you everything I've learned. Chantilly is the name of a commune, an administrative division in northern France, some 40 kilometers, which is about 25 miles north-northeast from Paris. In that same region, there is a historic Renaissance-style castle, Château de Chantilly, where between the years 1730 and 1800 was produced French soft-paste porcelain. The name of the porcelain, surprise surprise, was of course Chantilly. In the same castle, you will find something called Chantilly Codex, a manuscript of medieval music that dates from 14th century. In the 17th century, another great invention was born there. It was Chantilly lace, a handmade bobbin lace made in linen and silk. Interestingly enough, the most popular lace at the time was black Chantilly lace. The biggest surprise for me was that there was a cat breed named Chantilly Tiffany Cat. According to Wikipedia, this breed started in 1969 and became extinct in 2015, and naturally didn't have anything in common with the French castle, let alone the famous American luxury jewelry retailer Tiffany. Well, my head is spinning from all this Chantilly talk, so I'll get down to my favorite Chantilly, and that is Chantilly cream, of course. Crème Chantilly is another name for whipped cream. The difference between whipped cream and crème chantilly in my mind is that chantilly contains sugar, that's all. Some authors distinguish between the two, however, most authors treat the two as synonyms. As it is quite often the case, history of this treat is a bit vague, to say the least. You will find that a famous mid-17th century French chef, François Vatel, who worked at the Château de Chantilly, invented this cream. But that is not the truth. As a matter of fact, the name Chantilly is first connected with whipped cream in the mid-18th century, when Louis-Henri de Bourbon, Prince de Condé, owner at that time of the domain de Chantilly, built the hamlet of Chantilly. The Prince of Condé frequently organized dinners at the hamlet, and some A-list celebrities ate there. Emperor Joseph II, Marie Antoinette's brother, the daughters of Louis XV and the like often visited, and this place soon became known for fine dining. Among other delicacies, a delicious light cream was served, and soon it became known as crème chantilly, or so they say. Anyway, as the famous poet once said, "What's in a name? That which we call chantilly by any other word would taste as sweet." So, let's create some sweetness, shall we? As usual, the recipe is on my site. The link is down below. To make chantilly cream, I'm gonna put the cold whipping cream that contains 35% fat into a cold bowl. I'm gonna add sifted powdered sugar and vanilla powder into my cream. Then I will whip it using my balloon whisk until soft peaks form. To make chantilly cream in a stand mixer, I'm gonna put the cold whipping cream that contains 35% fat into a bowl of a stand mixer fitted with whisk attachment. I'm gonna add sifted powdered sugar and vanilla powder into the cream. Then I'm gonna whisk it on medium speed until soft peaks form. To make Chantilly cream, in my cream whipper, I'm gonna add sifted powdered sugar and vanilla powder into my cold cream and stir well to combine. I'll pour the mixture into my cream whipper that I've put in the fridge for about half an hour. Now I'm gonna screw the head tightly. Next thing I need to do is put N2O whipped cream charger into the cartridge holder and screw well. When all the gas is inside and I can no longer hear it, I'm gonna remove the cartridge holder and screw the safety cap in its place. All I need to do now is shake a couple of times and squeeze the handle. And that's it! My delicious Chantilly cream is done! I'm Teresa. Thanks for watching my video. I hope you liked it. If you want to stay in touch, follow me on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. And of course, visit my site where you can find elaborate posts with lots of pictures, additional information and recipes that follow my every video. Also, on my site you can download my free 365 pages ebook, The Pastry Chef, and maybe buy me a macaroon, if you think that I've earned it. Now, before you go, please hit the like button and subscribe to my YouTube channel. That really helps a lot. Finally, and this is the most important thing, don't forget to create sweetness every day, because sweetness is happiness. See you in my next video. Bye!